Hey guys, how's it going? I uploaded a video last week called My Infinity is Bigger Than Your Infinity, all about the different sizes of infinity in Cantor sets. In it, I went through two proofs about why the real numbers are not infinitely countable or enumerable, and there was a lot of confusion about the first one. So the reason for the confusion was my fault. I tried to sketch out the proof, but I also didn't want the video to be too long. So I tried to go through it quite quickly, but in doing that, I left out some major details and basically gave you an incomplete proof. I know there's nothing more frustrating than feeling like you didn't understand something, especially when it's not your fault. So I decided to make this video going through the proof again from start to finish, and hopefully that will clear any of the confusion and questions that you have. So here we go. Suppose someone says they have a list of all the real numbers. You want to step on their dreams and show them that their list is missing a real number. Before we get into the details of how we're going to do this, to avoid confusion, I want to give the overall strategy of what we're doing. Starting from an arbitrary interval on the real line, the goal will be to shrink that interval by using the real list in such a way that we can show that if the process of shrinking doesn't converge to a number, then all the reals can't be on the list. Then we'll show that if it does converge to a number, then either it must take an infinite amount of time to do so, meaning that the number the interval converges to can't be on the list, or it takes a finite amount of time to converge, meaning that the list must be missing some other real numbers. If that made absolutely no sense, don't worry. It will, I hope. All right, let's get started. Here we're defining a process for creating and shrinking an interval on the real line. Start with two real numbers from the list, alpha 1 and a larger number, beta 1. Now find the first two numbers from the list that are between alpha 1 and beta 1, alpha 2 and beta 2. Keep going with this pattern. For any alpha and beta n, find the first two distinct numbers from the list that are between them, alpha and beta n plus 1. If you don't find a number, the process stops. If you only find one number between alpha n and beta n, alpha n plus 1 is equal to beta n plus 1. Now we have two series, the alpha series and the beta series. We can take the limit of those series, in other words, what the alpha and the beta series converge to, and call them alpha infinity and beta infinity. In a full mathematical proof, we would have to show that the series do in fact converge, but just take my word for it. Now, these limits have to be the same number. If there were a gap between alpha infinity and beta infinity, then there would be reals in between. For example, alpha infinity plus beta infinity divided by 2. So then the interval must converge to a point, which means alpha infinity is equal to beta infinity. We'll call this number eta, the funny looking n. Now we're going to show two scenarios, one where the series converge to eta in a finite number of steps, and one where it takes an infinite number of steps, and then show that both scenarios mean there are some reals missing from the list. Suppose this real number eta is on the list, which means it takes a finite number of steps to converge to it. We'll label this finite number of steps m. Now look at the alpha and beta terms just before eta, alpha m minus 1 and beta m minus 1. According to how the reals are defined, there should be an infinite amount of real numbers between them, like any weighted average between the two. So then if we do find the real number eta, that means we're missing all the real numbers between alpha m minus 1 and beta m minus 1 except eta. So in the case where the series converge to eta in a finite number of steps and eta is on the list, there are real numbers that aren't. So then, what if it takes an infinite amount of steps to converge to eta? Well, that means there are an infinite amount of alphas and betas that the process picked before it. Because of how we defined our process, they must have come before it on the list. To put it another way, say you ask your friend, what natural number does eta correspond to on the list? What would he say? Infinity isn't an answer, and if he gives any natural number like 300 billion and 49, you can say, well, no it's not because there are an infinite number of alphas and betas before it. Contrasting this to any enumerable set like the rationals, for any number, your friend would be able to tell you the natural number that it corresponds to. In the previous video, we showed how every element in an infinitely enumerable list could be mapped to the set of natural numbers. For the set of reals, we've shown this can't hold.
So the real number eta cannot be on the list. Therefore, the list is never complete and the real numbers are non-enumerable.
So just to recap what we've done, there are three critical cases we analyze to show that the argument works. Case 1. The alpha series and the beta series don't converge to the same limit, but this means we're missing any real number in between the alpha and beta limit. So in this case, the list is missing reals. Case 2. The series converge to the same limit eta in a finite number of steps m. But this means that the alpha and beta before eta, alpha m-1 and beta m-1, which must be distinct, have an infinite number of reals in between them, which can't be on the list. Otherwise, the process wouldn't have converged to the limit eta yet. So in this case, there are also reals that aren't on the list. Case 3. It takes an infinite amount of steps to converge to the limit eta. But then there needs to be an infinite amount of alphas and betas on the list before it, so eta itself cannot be on the list.
But why doesn't this argument work for enumerable sets like the rationals? Well, we're generating this number eta in a pretty complicated way. We're taking the limit of two infinite series and saying this number is what they converge to. But the way the real numbers are defined means we could prove that eta is real. But for the argument to work with rationals, we would have to show that eta is a rational number. But it turns out to be impossible to show that eta can be expressed as a ratio of two integers. We need a more expressive number system to include this abstractly defined number. What makes this argument so powerful is that it's a self-referential argument, which basically uses the list to generate a number that can't be on it.
So yeah, that's the complete proof. If you still have questions, I've linked a bunch of sources in the description. Again, sorry for the initial confusion and thank you for your patience. See you in the next video. Bye.